The petroleum gas is also called LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas. This LPG consists of mainly butane. Apart from butane, it has other components in small quantities, like for example ethane and propane. This LPG catches the fire easily and burns to produce lot of heat. Now let's see the uses of LPG. The LPG are used as the domestic gas cylinders, the gas cylinders which we use at home for cooking purposes. This LPG basically consists of the liquefied petroleum gas inside the cylinder. The gas inside the cylinder is at extreme pressure. Now the butane has the property that when the extreme pressure is applied to it, then it gets converted into the liquid form. So when it is kept inside the cylinder, then the butane is under extreme pressure and thus it gets converted into the liquid. Thus it is called liquefied petroleum gas. Now as soon as you turn the knob of the gas stove for cooking purpose, then the pressure is released. Thus the liquid butane gets converted into the gaseous form and it eventually catches fire. Now as soon as the fire or the flame start burning, you can cook the food. It has the chemical property that when the butane burns, then it produces a blue flame. If you use LPG at home, then in that condition you have to be very, very careful. That is, no smoking near the gas cylinder, no naked fire lights near the gas cylinder, and the rubber which connects the cylinder to that of the gas should be properly checked. Apart from that, you need to close the knob of the gas cylinder when the cooking purpose is done. And the cooking or the gas cylinder is always used when there is an open window. Apart from that, the LPG produces a strange smell. That is, it is not odorless. It has a particular smell. So if you found that there is smell inside the kitchen or around the area of LPG, then you should first open all the windows or the doors so that the LPG should move out. So this is how the LPG needs to be handled with proper precaution. Now let's talk about another fuel, that is natural gas. The natural gas is also highly flammable. When it burns, it produces too much amount of heat energy. It contains mainly methane. Apart from that, ethane and propane are also present in it. This natural gas is taken out from the deep earth surface. When the petrol is taken out from the earth surface, then first the natural gas gushes out because the natural gas is present above the petroleum. So how the natural gas is extracted? Is it extracted from the oil wells? How it is formed? It is formed in the same way as the petrol is formed, that is by the buried dead organism. The natural gas are used in various purposes, in domestic and industrial purposes for fuel. Third, for CNG, that is compressed natural gases, which is used in transportation. In domestic purpose, natural gas is very useful to us. Like for example, the natural gas can be used as a gas stove. It can be used as a fireplace. It can be used as a water heater. It can also be used as a grilling, air conditioner, hot tub heater, and so on. The fossil fuels are very advantageous to us in many applications. But apart from it, there are various disadvantages also. It causes too much pollution. It is very harmful for the environment. Now let's see the cases one by one that how it affects the environment. These fossil fuels produce very harmful gases like sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. These gases, when they get mixed into the environment and their content becomes very high, then it causes acid rain. These acid rains are very harmful. It may damage the farms and may even cause the threatening to the living organisms. Many sculptures, many buildings even get deteriorated due to this acid rain. Second point is that the poisonous gases which I am talking about, this fossil fuel produces carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide is not poisonous to us, but it may affect in the long run. When much carbon dioxide is released in the environment, then it increases the global warming. It is a threat for us to increase the temperature of the environment. That is, when the carbon dioxide is released into the environment, then it increases the greenhouse effect. This greenhouse effect increases the temperature of the environment and thus is a threat for global warming. The third important point is that the coal, when it is burned, it produces too much smoke and leaves behind too much ash, which is also very harmful. The next point is that when the fossil fuels are burned, then they produce some radioactive materials. The radioactive materials like uranium and thorium into the environment. And this is produced when the coal is burned. So it is also very harmful for the environment. The fossil fuels are the non-renewable and the conventional sources of energy. According to it, these are present in limited amount on the Earth's surface. If they are once exhausted, then it takes millions of years to reconvert it or to renew it, which is impossible in a particular lifespan. That means we can say so that it is impossible to renew it again. So as the demand of energy is increasing day by day, but due to its limited supply on the Earth's surface, a day will come when it will get fully exhausted. That is called energy crisis. In order to meet this demand, we need to move towards some alternate source of energy. These alternate source of energy should be environmental friendly and it should be according to the environment and according to the humanity.